10 Cats Does Countdown. John Richardson. John Rock. Reginald D. Hunter. Ashling B. Holly Walsh. Susie Dent. And Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
Welcome to AI of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, 557 people in England speak Cornish as their first language? I say speak. They look up from their pasty long enough to grunt to their wife, who's also their sister. A leading sociologist has found that 1 in 20 men believe themselves to be the father of their child when, in fact, they aren't. Fascinating stuff. Although, of course, when I say leading sociologist, I mean Jeremy Kyle. And the Kama Sutra lists 64 different sexual positions, or 65 if you count the one where the middle-aged man sits alone in front of my computer. His computer. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's John Richardson. John should try his hand on the X Factor. He can't sing or dance, but if you're looking for tragic backstory, he's world-class.
Well, I can sing and dance, actually. I just keep that very well hidden.
Let's have some song and dance. Come on, break it out.
And I think that'll do. It's important to always leave them wanting less.
OK, I shouldn't be mean. John was actually bullied at school, and to this day, he still washes his face in a flushing toilet. Look, the bigger boys are laughing at you. And John's teammate this evening, it's Ashling B. Charming, funny and, dare I say it, easy on the eye, Ashling is very much Ireland's answer to Sean Locke. Up against them this evening is Sean Locke. Despite not always winning on Countdown, Sean really throws himself into it like a seagull flying into a patio window. And joining Sean tonight is Reginald D. Hunter. Reg first came to the UK to study at RADA. You may not think Reg has got much of an acting range, but he's actually a 23-year-old white woman from Surrey. Reg said he'd only do shitty TV shows if he was having to settle down because his girlfriend was pregnant, so I'm guessing congratulations are in order.
That's right, Jimmy. All of them are pregnant.
I'm not.
But then after the show, we'll see what we can do about that, baby.
Reg, have you seen the show before?
I have seen a minute or two of it, and I warn you in advance that I'm not going to be particularly good at it. However, if you ever do 8 out of 10 Cats meets Call of Duty, I might be your man.
Do you think Countdown would be big if they tried to launch it in America?
No. See, over here, audiences, comedy audiences will reward a comedian for being clever. They're like, oh, that's very clever, very good, it's quite clever. But in America, when you do clever, they sit there and they go, get to the funny part.
Yeah, I think if Countdown's too intellectual, then I think AI 10 Cats Does Countdown, I think we're in with a shot. Hello, America. You like things dumbed down? You're welcome. Sean, if there was anything you wish you could do better, what would it be?
I think I'd like to be a less considerate lover. I never pay attention to my own needs. I'm always just focused, you know, on the other person's needs.
Do you ever show your sensitive side?
Yeah. I've shown it twice. Once to my wife, and another time I slowed down for a horse.
OK, John, what did you want to be when you were growing up?
I had two things I wanted. One was to win Countdown, and the other was a World Wrestling Federation Royal Rumble title. So, it's very much one down, one to go for me. Look out for Grumble Bum at the next Royal Rumble. Making his debut in his little pants.
I think if you were allowed a taser, you got a chance. You have to walk around and just go...
Ashley, what's your favourite Irish phrase?
I have a friend who only speaks in Irish phrases. He just goes, ah, sure listen, look it, sure listen, we'll be grand, sure Rolling Stone got us no moss. In 10 years' time, we'll all be dead or laughing at something else. And you're kind of like, yeah, but I was asking for directions to your house, Sean, so I don't really know. Ah, sure listen, look at too many cooks, you know yourself.
Now, I also noticed earlier, I noticed you're wearing a very nice jumper with a robin on your sweater.
Yeah.
This evening, but if you're the way your hair's sort of hanging over the beak, it looks like a potato. Have you got a mascot today?
Yes, I do have a mascot actually. The last time I did the show, I was a little bit nervous. I feel like I lost focus and I wasn't entirely together. And so, yeah, I've been really trying my hardest and practicing with a really supportive, motivating beatboxing friend, obviously. So, you know, just to have him around, he makes me feel better and more confident about myself. He's always testing me on things. Thanks a million, Ross. Like, say, for example, so we'll try one now and just give it a go. So looking for a 9-letter on this. Possibly, show busy?
Not for show busy yet.
Great, good, going well. So, let's try another one now. And again, I want to go for nine on this, Susie. Beatboxer!
Beatboxer!
Oh, brilliant, yeah, great. Another thing now, what's it? Oh, I'm not great with the numbers now. John, do you remember, wasn't very good at the numbers at all, but let me just see. 50 plus 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 50 plus
John, have you got a mascot this evening?
Well, a bit like Ashling, really. It's more of a motivational device. So I've brought these selection of chilies with me, and any time I do not score points in a round, I will eat a chili.
Chili?
I mean, not the green bit.
So you'll eat all of the red bit of that. Can we choose which chili?
You can choose the chili, Sean, because it ain't gonna happen.
How are you with spicy food?
Hate it. Tend to be instantly sick. Unless it goes down, in which case, more of a problem tomorrow.
Okay, fine, let's definitely do that. Reg, have you got a mascot?
Yes. His name is Pimbleton. And he's been with me for over 3 decades now, and he means a lot to me. And I wish I had something more clever or funny or witty to say about him, but I wouldn't disrespect him like that.
How long have you and Pimbleton been together?
For a long time, baby.
Oh.
How did you make that sound sexy?
Anyone can do that, though. I say the same thing, it sounds sexy.
Go on.
Go on.
For a long time, baby.
Sean, have you got a mascot this evening?
I mean, I've given up on the whole mascot thing. Obviously, it makes no difference. So I'm just using this as a place to display a lot of my ingenuity, like to solve problems. And I think a problem that's looming up for many of us, not just in this country, in many countries, a really serious problem is... Well, it's the problem of drinking at the Qatar World Cup. Something that keeps me awake at night, that you go to a match and you won't be able to access alcohol in any form whatsoever. And I've come up with a couple of solutions. Firstly, I think a very good way to get alcohol into a stadium in a country which is where it's going to be 45 degrees is in suntan lotion. Back to 50, no, 50%. You just open that up.
It's a lively one.
Yeah, it's a lively one. That is. I hope I know who filled this. There we go, that's it. Oh. And then I thought to myself, you're in the stadium, and we all know the pleasure and fun that can be had from a drinking hat.
Sure.
Yeah.
Lovely drinking hat. But will they allow drinking hats?
Well, they will allow drinking hats under these circumstances.
Let's take a look at this.
So it's a drinking hat. But it comes with very discreet. And you can say, I've got really bad asthma and I need oxygen.
I like the idea in 50 degrees you'll be wearing a woolen bobble hat.
Let's play Countdown.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Holly Walsh. OK, now, you went on Celebrity Mastermind.
Yeah.
Your special subject was, I believe, badgers.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, when I was six, I was obsessed with badgers. I just didn't think about anything else other than badgers. And then when someone said to me, when I was...
Were you raised by badgers?
And then, when they asked me, age 31 or whatever, oh, what would your specialist subject be? I was like, badgers, of course. But I hadn't thought about badgers for... What's 31 minus that many years?
25.
And he's been drinking.
With Holly this evening is, of course, Susie Dent. Susie, how do you unwind after a hard day's counting down?
Well, there is one thing that Rachel and I do, and I blame Rachel entirely for this.
Oh, awesome.
Rachel introduced me to this website.
Oh, that one. And
it's basically, you know, we love cats, and we quite like men, so it's poses of men and cats.
And I bought you the calendar, actually, Rachel.
Oh, to show you here. This is the kind of thing we look at. What else can I show you? Ooh. There you go.
Wow. It's just what? So half. It's half a sexy man.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's got something for everyone, as long as you like men or cats.
Oh, that's the best one. Stay on that. That's like the weirdest ever hold up. That is hot stuff. I'm loving it. Oh.
Do they never make the men do what the cat decides to do? Like, one of a man just licking his underarm?
Or he's shitting in a park.
That is pretty good. And in charge of the numbers, it is Rachel Riley. Now, Rachel, if you go out with friends for dinner, do they always expect you to divide the bill?
On my birthday last year, my friend decided it was a treat for me, so I didn't have to divide the bill, but we accidentally left a 25-cent tip. Because it turns out no one else can do maths drunk.
Have you ever done Countdown drunk? How many?
There was one time when Nick moved the filming, so we were actually filming on a Sunday, and the night before, one of my best friends got married, so I probably was still a little bit drunk from the night before. But I could still do the numbers, it was fine.
Sure. OK, tonight, the prize the teams will be competing for is this, the Countdown Tool Belt. Funny if you can see the wood there, it's pretty impressive.
That would be more impressive if there was a tiny cat doing the same thing.
OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for our first game. Sean and Reg, your turn to pick the letters.
Vowel, please.
Thank you, Sean.
No worries.
You.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
L.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
Q.
Write any of these down. That's just a tip. I'll have another consonant, please.
F.
And a vowel.
And the last one. Another U.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock.
Ha ha ha!
John, what have you got?
A 6.
Ashling?
5.
Reg?
I got 7.
Sean?
5.
Okay, Ashling, you're 5?
Trail.
Trail?
Yeah.
Is trail a word? Yes, it is. Sean, you're 5?
Frail.
Is frail a word?
Yes, it is.
John, you're 6?
Ritual.
Oh.
Is ritual a word? Yes, it is. And Reg, you're 7?
Fartaloo.
Fartaloo. How are you spelling fartaloo?
F-A-R-T-I-L-U.
And the definition of fartaloo?
You know the people who invented a portaloo? Well, fartaloo... fartaloo was their first attempt.
Is it in the dictionary?
It's not there. I wish it was.
What the hell kind of dictionary are you using?
Well, that's good, because I genuinely shit my pants when you said 7.
So you've avoided a chili, John, and 6 points to you. Holly, Susie, could they have done any better?
Well, artful. That was the other 6.
Right, OK. So at the end of that, John and Ashling are in the lead with 6 points. on to our first numbers round. OK, John and Ashling, your turn to pick the numbers.
After you.
Oh, thank you, John. Could I have 2 big ones, please?
And 4 little ones.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Or, yeah.
Yeah.
It's harder with 2 little ones, but I kind of want to see John eat some chilies.
No, let's not play around.
But is it just if you don't score the max, or if you just got to lose?
We'll discuss the wording if and when.
Okay, right, we've got 8, 9, 10, another 8. This could be hard. And 75 and 50. And the target, 985.
Okay, the time starts now. No one distract John. Make sure John focuses here. Fuck. No, it's okay. You've still got 15 seconds, John. John, you've got 10 seconds.
Fuck off.
Easy, dude. Sean, for the love of God, get this.
Charles.
Okay, John, did you get it?
No.
Okay. Ashling, are you there to save him?
I am, if no one else gets it right.
What did you get?
I got 750.
Okay, all right, I see what's happened there. Yeah. Reg, did you get it?
No, as a matter of fact, I didn't even come reasonably close.
Sean.
I got 975, I think.
975, that would be close enough. How did you do that?
Well,
what did you get, John?
Well, I got 989.
Oh, it's a bit late for that, isn't it?
All right, Sean, show us how you did it.
9 minus 8 is 1.
9 minus 8, 1.
50 divided by 8.
50 over... what? you're not allowed fractions.
Are you going to 50, then?
No, it's...
Well, I didn't say that. Six. Nobody says you can't have fractions.
6 1/4.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Oh, John, you could not be safer, dude.
I feel like I've eaten one. I'm on fire.
Hang on a sec. Does 9 go into 50? 10 goes into 50, doesn't it? That's it. That's 5. 5 plus 8...
Plus, yeah.
It's 13.
13.
Times 75.
Times 75, 975.
That's it.
Okay, so that's 5 points for Sean. Now, John, you said you didn't get it, so you can't declare after that, is the rules of the game.
You didn't ask me what I'd got, though. You asked me, did you get it?
And you said no.
And therefore, you offered me no opportunity to tell you what I had. You pigeonholed me.
Maybe you should just man up and eat a chili, John. Sean, would you like to... would you care to pick a chili?
I'll just do it like this. I won't do it, because I'll do it like Lucky Dip. There you go, that one. Oh!
OK, just in one, I think.
I'd wipe it under your arm. So, yeah. Does that
kill the power of it, does it?
Yeah. It's just Sean hasn't washed his hands.
Oh, John.
Oh, you've got a lovely little bit of chilli left there.
John, come on, don't... Seriously, don't waste it.
How are you feeling, John?
Rachel, could that be done?
I've got a lot of ways for one away, but I've no idea if it can be done.
OK, well, come and eat your chilli. I'm not even joking, come and
do
eat your chilli.
Shall I have to eat your chilli? How bad is it, John?
I'll talk again later.
OK, Russian roulette.
This one.
The interesting thing about it...
Do you eat the whole thing?
The interesting thing about it is that it gets worse. It starts off all right. And then it just progressively deteriorates.
Yeah, that'd be fine. You'll probably be fine.
It would be really good for my...
That was nails, isn't it?
OK, time to go across to Dictionary Corner. Holly, what have you got for us?
Well, I don't know if you know this about me, Jimmy, but I'm actually quite a prude. I find it very awkward talking about sex. I've always been like this. When I was a teenager, I think the closest I came to having sex was when I was doing lengths in the local pool and a man butterflied over me. But I lost my virginity very late in the end, to the point where when it finally happened, I wasn't so much deflowered as deadheaded. I think part of it is because I'm British. I think it's because, you know, we're not very good at talking about sex. Not like the Americans. You look at the Americans, those guys have nailed it. Like, Reg, look at the sporting analogy that you guys use. You've got the American base system. But we've all seen high school movies. You know, first base, bit of French kissing. Second base, a bit of upstairs, downstairs. Third base, the old pink recorder. then the full home run. That's the American sporting analogy for sex. But when I look at that... What's yours?
So first base is kissing. Second base is rubbing a woman's breast. Third base is being able to give her the four fingers of fury.
Yeah. Oh, Mr. Hunter, you're making me blush.
The four fingers of fury?
Yeah, the triple F's. Four finger fury, baby.
Oh, the four finger.
Four.
No, I thought you were saying four fingers.
Four fingers.
Well, that's okay then. Now, Holly, for someone who's just said I'm a little bit British and prudish, I imagine you have comments to make.
I don't think the British could deal with that system. I think that's a bit too full on for us. I think if we had to
Yeah, because y'all like rounders, so of course, yeah.
I think if we had to have a sporting analogy for sex, it'd probably be the British cross-country running system. That's 42 different checkpoints over rough terrain. It starts with meet in the kitchen at a crap party, obligatory Game of Thrones chat. Extensive background check, Google. Look through every single photo of them online. See them with their arm around a person in a photo from 2009. Develop a rational hatred of that person. Like photo by mistake. Cringe. Then up to 12, you're just trying really hard to play it cool. Try hard not to think about them. 13, download album they've mentioned in passing. 18, listen to album and repeat and imagine your wedding. 19, give their number for friend. 21, compose text. 22, send text. 23, realise text sounds psychotic. 24, cringe. It's not till 26 that you actually meet, and then it's just wine, 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 wine. Snog. Jaeger bomb. Sexy times. Apologise.
Ladies and gentlemen, Holly Walsh. The scores at the moment are Sean and Reg have 5, John and Aisling in the lead with 6. And here is your teaser. The words are, I am in Reg. The clue is, this is really painful. That's, I am in Reg. This is really painful. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were, I am in Reg, and the clue was, this is really painful. It was, of course, migraine. OK, time to mix things up a little bit. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sean and Aisling. So, Aisling, your turn to choose the letters.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Aisling.
Yes, and then can I get a vowel, please?
I.
And then can I get another vowel?
A.
And another vowel?
E.
Oh, thought I was going to go to you, Maria, there for a second. then a consonant again, please.
N.
A vowel, please.
O.
One more vowel.
U.
Then a consonant.
R.
And another consonant.
And the last one. T.
OK, and your time starts now. You got?
I have gotten 5.
Mm. Okay, Sean, how'd you do?
Same. 5.
5. Okay, well, let's hear your 5, Sean.
Intro.
Intro. Can we have intro, Susie?
You can have intro.
Okay. Aisling, what'd you get?
I got toner.
Ooh. Mm. 5 points to both teams.
Yay!
Pretty easy. Could they have done any better?
Well, there were 2 7s you could have got.
Oh.
Taurine.
Like a bull.
Like a bull.
And routine.
Oh, man. I had root. I just didn't get root.
Horrible feeling, isn't it? At least you're feeling empty inside.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Rach have 10. John and Aisling still in the lead with 11. Right, now time for Reg and John to go head-to-head. So, Reg, your turn to pick the numbers.
OK. Give me a 12. Give me 1 from the bottom, and then I want 2 in the middle there. I want cheese and tomatoes. No. And give me 2 from the top there.
2 from the top.
And then give me 1 more bad boy from the bottom there again.
There we go. I'll hook you up. Right, for this round, we've got 2, 8, 6, 1, and the large one's 50 and 75. And the target, 360.
Mm. OK, and your time starts now. So the target was 360. Reg, did you get it?
No, I didn't get that.
What did you get, Reg?
We're playing that fucking role now, are we?
Someone's a little bit emotional.
The chili's just hit my emotional region. Fire.
What would you get, Reg?
I came in with 280.
280. John, how'd you do?
I got 360.
OK, all right, John, how'd you get it? Aisling's been taken out by fumes.
That felt so good.
6 + 1 = 7.
6 + 1 = 7.
Multiplied by 50.
350.
+8 + 2.
Yeah, well done. 360.
So 10 points to John. And no chili. OK, time to go again to Dictionary Corner. What have you got for us this time, Molly?
Well, my 2 favourite things in life are real ale and medieval art. I'm basically a beardy weirdy trapped in the face of a young Mary Berry.
That is uncanny.
So
tell you what I love about medieval art. I specifically love medieval manuscripts, which is why being a Dictionary Corner is the best place in the world for me. And I'll tell you why I love them. Because there's this thing called marginalia. This is honestly true, I'm not making it up. And basically, it's what happened in the margins in these really famous old books. So let me give you an example. Here is a picture of Alexander the Great playing chess with a bunch of aristocrats. So far, so dull, I'm sure you're all thinking. But what if I was to tell you that for absolutely no reason, another monk had somewhat ruined the moment by drawing a picture of a man with a finger up his asshole?
Is that, I mean, that's a genuine...
This is a genuine thing. This is from 1350. This is what these monks and nuns, they were awesome. They used to sit in their libraries and sort of nunneries and monasteries doing these really important old manuscripts. And then when they got a bit bored, they'd be like, yeah, let's just draw a picture of a man bumming an arrow. Or playing the fart trumpet. But my personal favourite is these nuns visiting a penis tree.
Ladies and gentlemen, Holly Walsh. The scores at the moment, Sean and Reg have 10, John and Aisling have 21, and here is your teaser. The words are neat shit, and the clue is just go for it. That's neat shit, just go for it. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were neat shit, and the clue was just go for it. It was, of course, hesitant. OK, before we go on, well, he doesn't work here anymore, but he keeps on turning up. Ladies and gentlemen, Joe Wilkinson. What's going on, Joe?
Tell you what's going on, Jimmy, is you fired me. make a bit of cash, done a bit of a deal, got a sponsor for the show. Show is now sponsored by a banister company. It's actually my half-brother Fabio's company. Yeah, it's called Fabio's Banisters. it's given me 60 quid. And all we have to do is do a little bit of advertising, don't we, sweetheart? Don't you even notice? You've got a fucking erection in it, you idiot! I said, don't have an erection!
I said, don't have an erection.
Sorry, Jimmy, he just really likes banisters. But I know what you're thinking, Jimmy, I know what you're thinking, I've already got a banister. Don't be a fucking idiot. There's lots of things you can use Fabio's banisters for. For example, why not use a banister as maybe a pepper grinder? Slash pizza slice. Oh, the other thing, Jimmy, just a little thing. I'm going to have to go back a little bit because I've changed the opening sequence of the show just a tiny bit. Again, I doubt you even notice.
Countdown is sponsored by Fabio's.
That's my other half brother, Raoul. he's sexually active.
Okay, on with the game, sponsored by Fabio's Banisters. Sean and Reg, your turn to choose the letters.
Oh, I'll speed the game on. I've done the letters for the first round. Done the letters.
Okay, well, look, using those letters there, good let's count down. Sponsored by Fabio's Banisters. Aisling, what have you got?
I've got banisters.
Let me just check and see if banisters is up there.
Yes, it's in there.
Oh. Okay, John, what have you got?
Eight. I got banister.
Oh. Sean, what have you got?
I was incredible because I got banisters as well.
Oh. Well done. Reg, what have you got?
I'm so sorry. I failed to take it seriously. So, I feel dumb as hell right now, I really do.
Now, you get double points for a nine-letter word, so both teams get 18 points there.
All right. Wow.
Holly, Susie, could they have done any better?
There was a 10-letter word.
What was the 10-letter word?
Abstainers.
Is that a record?
That would have been a record, yeah.
Oh, what a fucking hell, what a game.
The weird thing is, Joe, they say that sponsorship sometimes ruins TV shows, but it's made this better, really.
It's made a dog shit show slightly better.
So, at the end of that, John and Aisling are in the lead with 39 points. Whoa. On to another numbers round. OK, John and Aisling, you're to pick the numbers.
One big or two big?
Two.
I'll do this.
Yeah.
Okay. Get ready. Okay, let's do this.
Right. Two big and four small, please.
You're going to have to take over. I do not understand.
Oh, you were invaluable as usual, Joe. Thank
you. Do my best.
Two big ones and four little ones. Are you at least going to do the sum?
Yeah, if you like.
Cool. Great. The numbers are 3, 8, 4.
Why are they putting them up there?
And the large one's 50. I don't know why you got fired, Joe. Yeah. And 100.
Your attitude.
986.
Okay, and your time starts now. Aisling, did you get it?
Do you know? Oh my God, I got it! I have gotten it.
I've never made a woman do that before.
Yeah, I've gotten it.
I don't want to be Mr. Piss on the Fun, but did you get it using that sum there?
What happened?
I didn't get it.
Aisling, what happened there? Talk us through what happened.
Oh, who knows what happened, Jimmy?
I do.
I got to 900 and what did I get to?
You got to 900 and you took 24 off and instead of 876, you thought that was 986.
Really? I just saw what I wanted to see. Like many women with hope.
And I ruined it, like so many women with hope.
John, did you get it?
No, I got something else, Jimmy. 988 I got.
Sean, did you get it?
I got 983.
Reg, did you get it?
936.
Pretty good, you're getting much better. So, John, how did you get 988?
8 plus 2 is 10.
8 plus 2 is 10.
Times 100.
1,000.
Minus 4 times 3.
Minus the 12 for 4 times 3, yeah.
So, 7 points for John. Rachel, could it be done?
You could have said 3 minus 2 is 1 plus 8 is 9. 100 plus 4, 104. Times them together for 936 and add on the 50.
What the fuck?
Why have you got a tiara on?
Oh, I forgot I was still wearing it. Just had a bath. I wear it in the bath.
The scores at the moment, Sean and Reg have 28, John and Aisling have 46. And here is your final teaser. The words are I spy MILF. The clue is the easier the better. So I spy MILF, the easier the better. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were I spy MILF. The clue was the easier the better. It was, of course, simplify. OK, time for our final letters game. John and Aisling, your turn to choose the letters.
Oh, right. John, will you do half and half?
Yes.
Yeah. OK. So,
Joe, you can't smoke on television.
Oh, fuck.
Did you just inhale bubbles? Joe, what just happened there?
I was meant to blow and I forgot.
OK, pick your letters.
Rachel, can I get a whoop-whoop? Just a little joke there, lads, no big deal. May I have a vowel, please?
That's my section.
Thank you, Joe. Keep your word in mind.
E.
A consonant, please.
I'll go with that one.
Over to you.
G.
Vowel, please.
If this vowel is a G, you've got egg.
Another consonant, please.
D.
Then a consonant, Rachel.
S.
Egads.
And a vowel, please.
Ooh. Egadsy. Egadsy for seven.
And then one consonant, please, there, Rachel.
That's only six.
Shut up.
T.
Egadsy.
A vowel, please.
Igazio.
And then one more vowel, please, Joe.
One more vowel. Ivazigo. The E is silent.
Okay, and your 30 seconds starts now. John, what have you got?
Six.
Aisling?
I have six.
Reg?
Five.
Sean?
Six.
Reg, what was your five?
Just egad. Egad.
Egad. OK, Sean, you're six?
I went for staged, Jimmy.
Staged.
Could have had teased. Sedate.
John, you're six?
Seated.
Ugh.
Aisling, you're six?
I got to date.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
OK, so 6 points to both teams. What a high-scoring game. Could they have done any better?
They could have got an eight.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
What was the eight?
It's really hard as well. Gadishas. Gadishas. It's a flower.
From the deep south of America.
Like you.
I'm a flower from the deep south of America, baby. Thank you, baby.
See,
thank
I
you.
Can do it back to you.
I appreciate it. I think you like me a little bit better after I explain baseball to you.
Yeah.
OK, so Sean and Rachel have 34, John and Aisling have 52. OK, fingers on buzzers, time for today's countdown conundrum. Your time starts now. John.
Is it bumpiness?
Let's have a look. Yes, it is. Oh, with 2 seconds to go. So, So the final scores are Sean and Reg have 34, but tonight's winners by a huge margin with 62, John and Ashley. Congratulations, you're now the proud owner of this Countdown Tour Belt. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
The big wow of the week is Cucumber from the mind of Russell T Davis. Channel 4's hot new drama continues Thursday at 9 and catch up now with 4OD. But next up, Adam, Josh and Alex are live with Kathy Burke to dissect the week. It's the last leg.